After the successful launch of the South Asian Satellite GSAT-9 on board GSLV-Mk II, scientists of ISRO centers feel that it was a proud moment to be part of India's space diplomacy initiative and hear praise from Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Now, the team of scientists and engineers are focused on the next mission, the launch of GSLV Mk III boosted with fully indigenous cryogenic engine by this May end. In the previous GSLV launches, some parts of the indigenous cryogenic upper stage CUS engine were procured from Russia's, but this GSLV Mark II had more indigenous CUS with propellant acquisition system and umbilicals. This launch was first in terms of use of electric propulsion. GSLV Mark II was the 11th flight of Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle, GSLV, and the fourth consecutive success achieved by GSLV carrying indigenously-developed CUS. After the launch of GSLV-Mk on Friday, now we are focused on the developmental flight of GSLV-Mk 3D1, which will launch GSAT-19, a communication satellite with advanced spacecraft technologies including bus subsystem experiments in electrical propulsion system and indigenous lithium-ion battery. GSLV-Mk III project director Geosynchronous said, this GSLV-Mk III rocket with totally indigenous CUS will weigh about 3.5 tons as against the GSLV-Mk II vehicle with indigenous CUS stage weighing 2.2 tons, he said. Later, the PSLV-C38 will launch the Earth Observation Satellite CartoSat-2E by June 1 week.